you know, for DBs, especially at this level, you know, the smallest things tip off that the ball's coming. So try to give as late hands as possible to just try to hide that the ball's coming.
How can you think of all that in the space of like 30 yards in 2 seconds?
It's just a repetition thing. Yeah. Just something I've been working at for years.
Cool, thanks.
How many NFL games have you been to as a fan?
I've been to quite a few. My uncle used to play for the Jaguars. You know, so I grew up growing up watching NFL games, and you know, so I've been to quite a few.
Well, what was it like just experiencing as a player in an NFL stadium, finding your way, the pregame, you know, preparation, everything? Is much different from college, or how was it for you?
Yeah, I mean, everything's a little different. You know, everybody runs things a little different, but you know, definitely cool. A lot of great energy in the stadium, you know, from the fans. Turf feels great, felt great out here. So just excited to come out and compete a little bit today and try to put together a good scrimmage and try to walk off the field feeling good about what we did today.
What have you been able to learn from a veteran like Jesse James?
Oh, a lot. You know, he's a super wise, you know, football player, great guy off the field. So I just try to soak up everything he says. You know, being a young guy, super important. I think he's going into his fifth year. So, you know, he's played a lot of football, won a lot of football games, and he's definitely earned his stripes. So, you know, as much as I can learn from him, I'm going to do that.
As a female football player, I feel like you're thinking more about that last one more than the touchdown. How eager are you just to see the film and learn from that moment at the very end there?
Yeah. As a football player, you work so much on, you know, trying to do things right that I think you often think about the stuff that you did bad rather than what you did good. I definitely want to go in there and correct the things that, you know, I didn't do well. You know, you got to have a quick memory when you do well and when you do bad, move on to the next thing and try to get better every day, every week. So, you know, that's going to be the focus when I go in, watch the tape, is how do I get better.
And what did you see on the touchdown grab? Could you just explain to us the route you ran and how that developed?
Yeah, I just ran a vertical route up the field. Saw that it was man coverage. Knew that, you know, the ball was probably, you know, coming my way, you know, with a man-to-man look. Looked up, saw it out the corner of my eye. Just tried to slow down, show late hands so I didn't, you know, tip off to the DB, you know, the ball was coming. And, you know, shout out to David, you know, for throwing a ball out there for me. And, you know, I was just happy to be able to, you know, bring it down.
So my job is kind of control anything down the middle and deep. So I kind of knew it was going to be a play action pass. So after that, I was just reading the quarterback and I got a good jump on the ball. So I used to play center field, so after that, it just turns into tracking down a fly ball, going to get it.
Baseball skills are still working.
Oh yeah, definitely, yeah. The center field definitely helps with my ball skills. So
you came here with a reputation for making the most of your opportunities. Only played a third of the snaps last year, 4 picks. Why do you have such a knack of coming away with the ball?
I think it just comes down to being a football player. At the end of the day, that's what I am. You know, in the NFL, everybody runs fast, jumps high, and strong. So what's going to keep you here is being a good football player, and that's what I do. I come out, do my job, do what I'm supposed to do, and play football. That's it.
Also a good baseball player, apparently.
Yeah, a little bit. I don't know if I still have it, but I used to have it.
How deep did you go with baseball? I mean, did you play in college, or was it just high
school? No, I didn't. I committed to Furman for baseball, but then I decommitted and went to UConn for football. So.
I think on the next snap, you gave it to Andy Jones, I think, pretty good. I mean, that's...
Yeah, I honestly didn't want to hit him like that, but it was just the, I don't know, it's football. It's kind of the game moving fast. So when he turned around, I was coming with some force, so I kind of hit him hard, but that's my teammate. I'm trying to take care of it. We're trying to take care of each other. So I apologize to him after the scrimmage, but during the play, I didn't apologize.
And you hear your mom's here, is that right?
Yeah, my mom and dad are here.
Okay.
Yeah.
You took a while, you know, showing her around. You introduced her to Matt. Why is that important for you to have your parents here?
Just it's bigger than football. You know, just in a lifetime, just cool to accomplish and see and meet new people, good people, be around good people. It's not just that he's the head coach, he's my coach. It's you know, 10 years down the road, when I'm not playing, we're going to look back and remember this time. So it's not just about, you know, just football. It's creating memories and just throughout a lifetime.
Where are they in from?
Atlanta, Georgia. Atlanta, Georgia, yeah. So I'm very thankful for them to be able to, you know, come up here and support me and see me it's something I've dreamed of doing since I was a kid. So. That's going to be huge. You know, we have some forces up front, as y'all know, and once everybody's healthy, it's going to be scary just to see what they can do. And from a back-end standpoint, that's exactly what you want. The quicker they get to the quarterback, the more we can step in front of passes, you know, read the quarterback, good jumps, because the ball's going to come out. So that's going to help us.
Again, you guys all excited seeing a guy like Daniels coming to the fold, Trey Flower. You guys all kind
of definitely.
Talk amongst each other. Right?
We all licking our chops.
Well, obviously, we're very excited to be here tonight to have a little bit of Friday Night Lights down at our stadium with our team and, you know, our great fans. We're super excited to see everybody. I know the team's had a great day, you know, in anticipation of this. So, you know, for us, it's another great opportunity to get into our stadium, feel the energy of the fans, another great opportunity for us to compete. I think, like I mentioned the other day, you know, we're at a point now where I think we've installed a lot as far as the game is concerned. So a lot of different situational football, first down, second down, third down, 2 minute. Regular down and distance run and play actions, drop backs, all that stuff is in. So let's try to get as many reps as we can as a normal game. It'll be controlled though. You know, it'll be something that we're going to try to set up different situations and put as much pressure on everybody as we can and just keep pushing towards getting ready to play a real game next week. So we're excited. We're excited to be here tonight.
You didn't get an opportunity to do this last year, I think maybe because of the construction was still going on. Does the energy ramp up? Is this almost like a joint practice type atmosphere sometimes?
Yeah. Sure. I would say the energy definitely ramps up, especially with our fans being in the building and just being in our home stadium. You know, anytime you walk into this stadium, you can feel the excitement, the energy, and, you know, that's what everyone's looking forward to. Well, I think it means a lot to a lot of the guys. You know, I mean, it takes everybody a long time to get to this position. I think Nick's unbelievable. He loves this game. He's passionate about it. And, you know, when you go through something like that, it's definitely a reminder of, you know, how difficult this is. And he appreciates that every day. So, you know, he's just got to keep working to get better and grind it out. But it's certainly good to see him out on the football field. You know, I know last year it's long, but he approached it the right way and had his head down, just grinded it out, trying to learn as much as possible.
What did you guys see from Darius that allowed you to take
him off? Sure. You know, those situations with guys that, you know, are coming back or working through things, we have a protocol in place that we go through, and there's certainly still protocol to be had with the whole situation. You know, you never just kind of throw someone right out there. You got to think about everybody that's been on the practice field, how much more, you know, involved they've been with different drills or different situations and guys' movements and things like that. So it's just good to have them get out and, you know, do some drills and things like that and be able to see them. And we're certainly going to do everything we can to, you know, have them out there as much as we can, but also be smart about the entire situation because we know it is a long year.
Kind of following a little bit further than that, just because you have a couple guys still on there. If you don't get a guy back, say by today or by Sunday,
yep. Well, it's not necessarily a situation where we won't use them. It just depends on what the drills are, what the, you know, it's not all of it's going to be just team periods, you know. There'll be some individual periods. There'll be some group stuff where we're working just, you know, with ourselves. So we'll be able to get some of those drills in. We might have a guy that might take some of the individual specific fundamental work against another team. And you might ease them into some of the teamwork or not. Just depends on all the individual cases. Sure. I mean, it means everything to anytime we get anybody that's on our team that isn't out there practicing and they come back and they're excited to be out there and we're excited to have them. So we're just, you know, always focusing on the guys that are on the field and trying to make sure that they're improving. And, you know, it's a great team game and it's all about having everybody out there working together. I mean, I think everybody's important, right? It all has to work together. So that's why football is football. Good question. Yeah, you know, when we go back and evaluate it, I think there's certain things that we'll hopefully set up that we're going to look for, and certainly from a standpoint of execution and communication, that'll be a big part of it for us, and making sure that we're executing at a high level with those things. You know, I think some of the situations could stress the team out a little bit, and that's what we're trying to do, because the more we can simulate that in practice, then hopefully the better we respond in the game. Yeah, it's actually kind of worked out great. You know, it's been good for us, and You know, I certainly enjoy doing this on a Friday as opposed to any other night, and I think, you know, everyone's got an opportunity to come out. So it should be a good weekend event, hopefully. Yeah, Ty Law is awesome. I know Ty really well. He's, you know, he lived in the New England area, was around all the time. I was with him, obviously, early on in my career. Extreme competitor. I mean, he's an unbelievably tough guy. Someone to me that just was, you know, one of those guys I was around that really just dominated his position, dominated a game, and some of those plays he made and some of the biggest moments just shows you how clutch, how key, and what a critical player he was in those big games. And, you know, he's just an even better person. Like I said, I've kept up a really strong relationship with him since, and he's always asking how my family is and asking how things are going and just, you know, really involved with each other's lives. So super excited for him, so happy for him, and, you know, just great example for everybody. I'm sorry? I unfortunately will not be able to get to go. We're going to you know, stay here and concentrate on getting ready for next week. But I'm certainly, you know, thinking about him all day.
You had to break in a new field. I know it's the first time on a new
trail. Yeah.
Anything particular you don't want to do tonight?
It's a good question. You know, I think it actually is a good point of another reason for us to come down here tonight. We, you know, there's so much to get used to with different field surfaces and different you know, footwear that we can use in it. So I told the guys, look, you know, we're going to bring all the footwear we have, find something that's comfortable. I wanted to try to get that done before we got to next Thursday. And, you know, every field is different, no matter it's like, okay, this is the same turf as another stadium, but it's not. It's all about the fill and how much, you know, it goes, how it's installed. So there's so many little details to the surface that we're just trying to get familiar with it.
Two more for Coach.
It was just in progress.
Yep. Last question.
For the rookies, just a lot of guys have never even been in it. Some guys have never been in an NFL stadium.
Yeah.
How important is it to get them acclimated to where things are, all that stuff?
Yeah, 100%, especially at home. You know, even just our locker room. We have a game day routine we try to go through from a standpoint of getting ready, getting warmed up. It's going to be different here than it is at our facilities, whether it's the hot tubs, the cold tubs, the training room, the our area where we kind of stretch guys out and get warmed up. It's really important for them to get down here and get a visual of the stadium itself, where the clocks are, where's the play clock. That's important. These are things that we usually do when we go to opponent stadiums. We go out early and we check out, the lights. And certainly, you know, being indoors, but all indoor stadiums have different light structures, how they affect the ball when it's in the air. Some of them, the lights just themselves, you know, the glare that comes off them from that standpoint. So, it's just another opportunity for us to get comfortable in our home stadium. And especially, like you said, for the guys that are new that haven't had an opportunity to play here before. This is exciting. This is new. This is great. They're going to sure be wide-eyed for a little while, and then we're going to have to dial them back in and make sure they're paying attention to what's going on the field. Okay?
Thank you, guys.
All right, appreciate it. Thanks. Yep.
We improve the turnover, we increase the chance of Stafford scoring more and the offense scoring more. So that's what we're trying to do, is increase our turnover, get Stafford more opportunities to put us on his back, and let's go get these dubs.
Why do you think this defense is built to create more turnovers now?
I mean, I think all defense is built to create turnovers. And all 32 teams in the NFL, we're just trying to be the best at it.
Is there something about your group of players or your scheme or something that may lend you to do it better this year?
I mean, not really. I mean, we just got to do it. We just got to put our mind to it and find ways to get the ball to offense.
What do you mean to put the pads on for this night for all these fans?
Oh, good, good. They deserve it. You know, that's why my head's sounding everything I possibly can. And, they're the fans, man. They put a lot of hard work into this. They help us, motivate us to keep going forward. So, we owe it to them, and it's fun.
You love competition, and it's clear. You have Tom Brady coming to town this week. When you guys line up against each other, and do you anticipate being on the field? What do you make if you are out there?
We just go see how I go. If I'm out there, I'm ready to go. Shoot, if I ain't, I ain't. I'm just I'm ready to just work it, honestly. So that's all what it is.
How badly do you want to face him, though, this week?
It's not that big of a deal, to be honest. I mean, it's preseason. All right, we got 16 real games to get ready for.
Work you vets need in the preseason? Like, huh? A guy like you that's better,
I need all that because it's good reps. It's good reps. I love, and it's just long, but it's good reps though. Everybody need it. We all need to get our feet wet. So it's just good, man. It ain't nothing wrong with preseason, but like I said, what really counts is the 16. Who?
Andrew Adams.
Double A?
Yeah.
Hey, he ready. He got ball skills. I like it. I like ball skills. Yeah. I like guys like that.
Also played out a big hit today too.
Oh yeah, yeah. He do that. I don't do that.
Mm-hmm. Why not?
I'm not good at that. I'm a good tackler. I'm not a good big hitter.
Yeah,
he good at big hitting.
Yeah.
us into the hills. Oh, they let the wolves off of a leash. Should've finished the kill. We got ashes on our shoes and an outcast attitude. And we're all immune, cause we know the truth is viral. So out right now. No bones, no drugs.